Hello everyone, it's been a while since my last video. Last time I basically got most of the dome finished. All I'm waiting on now for the dome is basically to get the electronics and the inserts that go around those electronics and fit into the holes, mainly in the back of the dome. So I'll show you that at the end of this video where it's up to. But now I'm onto the legs. Now I've already cut one full leg out apart from the horseshoe on that one and a couple of the extra bits down the bottom. And I'm just about to cut out from this piece here. Managed to find out how to use this for the best possible. I'm going to be very minimal off cuts for this. Won't be usable at all for anything that I can think of. And I've been using that one there as my template, but it will also become a part of one of the legs when I have no further use for it. So yeah, that's where I'm up to, and next video we'll show these two legs put together and glued. And as you can see with this one, I've got the channel ready to go down the middle there. I've already got one over there ready to go as well. So here it is at the moment, looking pretty good. That's a nice little addition to my little miniature man cave. The eyepiece is done with a blue mica spray paint, and I think it pops a whole lot more than the galaxy blue that I got for all the panels and the pie panels. I don't know whether or not I'll repaint the pie panels in the same blue. I don't know if I'm going to really be that fussy, because it's hard to even notice it, to tell you the truth. I just didn't like it, the galaxy blue on the eye panel, on the radar eye, I think. It just didn't pop enough, so yeah. And I've got inside the radar eye is a black Christmas bauble, a large one. I've spray painted the inside of it black, get a nice amount of shine out of it now. Nice and hard and solid. Milk bottle plastic in here, and in here, that's only temporary of course, until I can make up or buy some proper logic displays for that. Use the same glue on this ring here, so that his head spins. Don't know what I'm going to do with these screws. Countersink them a little bit more, probably. Putty over and just put a silver paint over. Might be the best way. This rear logic here, once again, I might buy it or buy a 3D printer and just shrink the specs of it from standard down a little. Whole lens is looking good. The buttons here, still got to finish those. Bit of milk bottle plastic there. I'm going to pinstripe these ones here, a bit of painter's tape, leaving a little gap, and run a brush through there, very thin brush, probably just a dark grey, so it's not 100% standing out like black wood. And oh yes, and of course got to put in the washer I've got with the dome topped bolt painted blue. So yeah, anyways, that's where it's up to at the moment. That's looking legit, I've got to say. It's looking right on the money at the moment. I'm very happy, for a scratch build of course. If I was doing an official build, buying parts from other builders, this obviously would look just like the club spec ones, but that's not what I intended to do. I wanted to build it from scratch. Next step is the body. Doing skins first. Getting some white high impact polystyrene. Cut the skins out and stick straight to the surface of this PVC pipe. And from there, that's when I'll know what parts of this to cut out, like those. Yes, I know those ones are going in the opposite way. That was well before I drew them on, well before I knew what I was doing, really. Yes, so there you go. Looks good in my little man cave. My man cave being heavy metal stuff, because that's why I'm called Metal Nerd on YouTube. Oh, and some cool skateboard art up there, collectible boards from the 80s and 90s. And that's my PC setup. And more music stuff, Doctor Who, a bit nerdy. And some other Star Wars collectibles there. But this is the main attraction, of course. Until next time, see you.